Get ready to match the stars. Bill Anderson, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Riley, Barbara Rose, from Vegas, Bart Braverman, and Joyce Dillamont, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game PM. And now, here's the star of Match Game PM, Gene Rayburn.
Hi, John. Thank you for joining us here on Match Game PM. You're going to have a good time because they've opened up the lunatic asylum and released some of the buongiorno. Would you say hello to Nancy McCullough and Doug Smith, please? Welcome. Good luck to both of you. Let's get acquainted. Doug, please tell us about yourself.
I'm a single male student.
Good.
Unmarried. I'm from Provo, Utah. I just graduated from Brigham Young University.
All right. Woo.
And currently I'm a law student at Whittier College School of Law, studying corporate entertainment law.
Corporate entertainment law.
You've
that's very difficult.
Right,
what is this, if I may ask?
That's Fraternity Penn Intercollegiate Knights.
All right. Okay. Good luck, Doug. Nancy, tell us about yourself, please. Now, wait a minute.
I'm so nervous.
You had
She's
a funny life?
Ventilating.
No. No. Take a deep breath.
Give her a
now, I exhale. You have to exhale occasionally, you know.
I'm married. I know that.
You are? I can tell, and she's married to me. Okay.
And?
You live in?
Huntington Beach.
That's right. What? See, she's got it right so far. She's all right. You live in Huntington Beach and you're married. What's his name? It's gonna be all right. It's gonna be all right. Sam, George.
Dave, he's right.
Dave. I knew it was in my head. All right.
I'm sorry, sweetheart.
How long have you been married?
5 years.
5 years. Dave, have I got a girl for you? You have any children?
I have two girls.
Now, I don't want to hear about their names.
Oh, I...
Do you know their names?
Carrie's four and Megan's two.
Oh, good. That's good. See, she had a marvelous recovery. Where is what's his name?
Them. He's the third one.
Oh, there he is. Hey, Dad. Now, I want you to remember, Nancy.
Yes?
He's the one with the mustache. Just remember that. Dave is the one with the mustache, right. Okay, now here in Match Game PM, you'll each have three opportunities to match as many of our stars as you possibly can. Now, the one who's done that most often at the end of the third round will be the winner, and that person will go on to play the Big Money Super Match, which can pay off over $20,000. Let's go, Doug.
Could I have A, please?
Doug says he wants A, and A says... The chef said to his wife, I've got good news and bad news. The bad news is your mother was just flattened by a steamroller.
Oh, golly.
The good news is I've made her into a blank. The chef said to his wife, this is Doug's question. The chef said to his wife, I've got good news and bad news. The bad news is your mother was flattened by a steamroller.
She died.
The good news is I've made her into a blank.
A crepe?
Yeah! Okay. Whoa. Doug came up with the answer. Have you got it?
Crepe?
Yes.
I want to ask Doug a question.
Go ahead.
When you were in school in Provo, Utah, what radio station did you listen to?
KFTN. Country Western.
You own it.
I own that radio station. I also am going to make Doug mad. I said pancake.
That's
a crepe. Is that a crepe?
No,
is
that a crepe? No, crepe is rolled up, but a pancake is not. It's just flattened out. What have you got there?
He owns a radio station? I don't own the coat I'm wearing.
That's right.
I don't know
where have I gone wrong?
That's
She reminds me of me because we're both shy and targeted.
Similarities.
Right.
I said I made her into a gingerbread person.
Gingerbread person? So that's two. She's looking for a crepe Suzette or anything like that.
Too classy for this show.
Now, first of all, look at Jug. Does he look like a guy that could come up with an answer crepe?
No.
Do I look like a guy that can come up with an answer crepe?
I said crap.
Oh, yeah.
Crap.
So that's a match. We're done.
All right.
Good news is I've made her into a crepe.
Now you're going to see why I was fighting for Bill's pancake. Pancake.
Pancake. Yep.
Try.
Waffle.
A waffle.
A crepe is not rolled.
You can do no wrong here. Joyce, what have you got?
One of those women from the audience.
Well, after he slid her under the door, he then rolled her up, made a roast out of her.
A roast. So Doug picks up one. Nancy, listen to this. Al said, I am never going back to that rotten hospital. They're so money hungry, they even have coin-operated blanks. Hear that? Here we go. Al said, I'm never going back to that rotten hospital. They're so money hungry, they even have coin-operated blanks.
Bedpans?
Bedpans. She is hoping you are going to say bedpans.
Oh, I wish I had thought of bedpans.
You hadn't thought of that. No. What did you think
of,
Bill?
Can I change my answer?
No, too late for that. Nice try.
I said operating rooms.
Operating rooms? Put a nickel in, or a quarter, or whatever? Yes.
Well, I just can't get over the similarity between us. It just absolutely surprising.
Yes, of course. Surprising to me, too.
I said coin-operated nurses.
All right.
I said transfusion.
Transfusion. So well, far, yours is the best, Nancy.
Sure is.
And these are the experts, Barbara. They even have coin-operated what?
Bedpan.
Oh, yeah. There's one. Now, Bart, I know you have your clack out here.
Now, you know, I made fun of Barbara's answer because I thought, I looked at that lovely lady and I said, she's not
going to say that.
Is that sweet little girl going to say that?
Uh-huh. And she did.
I said never
bedpan.
Know.
Well, I said beds. I figured it would be beds.
Okay.
We'll get together after the show.
Right.
You're not supposed to mess.
Show us your bedpan.
Depends.
You need just one more to win.
No,
okay.
It's
one more to go ahead. It's the first round.
Bedpan.
So it's 2-1 to the first round. Now this is for you. 3-2-1. Here we go. All right, let's go to round two. Nancy, you're ahead 2-1. Let's go to you first.
Okay, A, please.
A for her.
A.
A. They just published the world's thinnest book. It's called My Accomplishments in Office, and it's written by blank.
Oh, he's such a bad person.
They just published the world's thinnest book. It's called My Accomplishments in Office. It's written by
Nixon.
All right. There may be others to whom this might apply. In this day and age.
Check the spelling at the country schools, how they taught the country boy to spell.
Oh, you've been peeking again, haven't you?
Uh-huh.
All right, I will. Let's see your card, Bill.
Well, I don't know. You're going to insult anybody with this, eh? I mean, a lot of people could be insulted. I said R.M. Nixon.
R.M. Nixon. Nixon.
Well, it was a small school in the country.
Well, that's all right.
I'm sorry. I'm
That's a match.
Joke.
That's all she cares about.
Presidency, you know?
Right. Spelling doesn't count here.
With whom we have had an off. Well, I can't go into that. There are so many good choices. Nixon was one, but Mr. Carter, with the help of his mother, is another one.
Right.
They don't sew that old lady's mouth up. I don't know what we're going to do.
Yes. Aw. Chuck. Charles. Why are you so weepy?
Because everyone has forgotten.
Everyone's forgotten
they
what?
They have forgotten the wonderful work of a great, and may I say, a truly great man, Chester A. Arthur.
Yes, that's fine. Oh, yes.
And his brilliant first lady, the very beautiful Miss Maybelle Arthur.
Maybelle.
I thought it was B. Arthur all along.
No, that was the daughter.
Oh, I see. Well, all right. What
My
do you got?
Inclination would be to put to Nixon, but the truth is he actually did quite a bit in office. I mean, he really, despite his foolishness, he did. But the person who really did zilch but fall down in the snow was Gerald Ford.
Gerald Ford. Yeah, nothing. So it's 3-1 at this point.
And he pardoned Nixon.
Here's a little riddle for you.
Oh, good.
Ready?
Yeah.
For a little riddle. Why did the cannibal eat Dean Martin? Oh. I shall tell you why. Because he likes his meat blanked. Here we go, Doug. Little riddle for you. Why did the cannibal eat Dean Martin? The answer, because he likes his meat blanked.
Marinated.
There
you go. That's it. Thank you.
Isn't that the same thing?
He likes his meat a la marinade. What do you say?
I spelled marinated. M-A-R-E, marinated. N-A-T-E-D,
that's perfectly okay.
All right. I said pickled or marinated.
Pickled or marinated. Okay, Doug, you picked up another one.
Just a minute, I have a several card answer here. I said marinated in bourbon, or is it vodka? Or maybe gin? One of them.
There it is, marinated in bourbon. That's all we need from you, and that's perfect.
I think the spelling is correct.
What have you got for
Is it my turn?
Yes.
Charles doesn't play this time? No. I said he liked his meat stewed.
Stewed is a good response, isn't it?
You know, I meant marinated.
You meant marinated?
I thought that's what this was, but that's, I mean, I don't cook, you know.
What did you say?
I said sautéed.
Well, that
I
could
thought,
be good.
I
that's
that
fried.
Isn't that marinated?
No.
No, no doubt.
Sautéed is lightly fried, which he always is.
You're right.
Lightly, what have you got?
I'm sorry, I
well,
thought that's what
Well, he's also
meant.
Always stewed. I said stewed.
Stewed is good. All right. So the score is tied 3-3, and we go to the final round, round 3. Nancy went first last time, so Doug, you go first this time.
Could I have A, please?
Yes, you may, sir.
Thank you.
A says this. Jessica said it's terrible being married to a baseball umpire. You're an eager bunch. In the middle of the night, he wakes me up and yells, blank. Here we go. Done. It's terrible being married to a baseball umpire. In the middle of the night, he wakes me up and he yells,
"You're out."
You're out. All right. He said, "You're out." What do you say to that, Barbara?
I said, "You're out."
You're out. All right. Four for him. Five is you're out. That's five for him. Joyce?
Take three bases.
You sure know a lot about baseball, don't you? With all those kids in the house, you ought to learn something about baseball by now. Now, Nancy, here's the way it is. You need two to tie. However, you match all three, you win it. Brett, Charles, and Bart play. The rest of you lay out, please.
Would you?
The nightclub owner said to the new comic, "Hey, I just ordered 10 dozen roses for you, kid. If you do good, I send the flowers to your dressing room. If you do bad, I send them to your blank." Ryan, you got the idea, buddy. Hello, Nancy. The nightclub owner said, "A new comic, I just ordered 10 dozen roses for you, kid. If you do good, I send the flowers to your dressing room. If you do bad, I send them to your blank."
To your grave?
Grave. Okay. She said grave. This may be a little difficult here if someone...
Now, is there going to be a big argument about grave and other words that we all know and love so well, like funeral?
Funeral is a man. 5-4 the score.
I want Italian. Funerale.
Funerale. Score is now tied 5-5, Nancy. If you match Bart, you win the game. What have you got?
What's it worth to you?
you for being here. Doug Smith. All right, there's been a little message for you. Hurry back and see how much money she wins. This little lady has a chance to win a really big bundle of money. We're going to have two audience matches for you here. Everything you win will be multiplied by 10, and good luck to you. Let's go with the first one. We polled the studio audience and said write down your best answer to this. Blank fault. $500 for the most popular answer, $250 for the second most popular, and $100 for the third most popular. Now, as you call on the celebrities, call on the ones who are looking at you in bright, eager anticipation. The others don't know nothing.
Well, Bart saved my life just now, so, Bart?
No fault, as in no fault insurance.
All right.
Okay.
I like that.
Barbara?
How about the old earthquake fault?
The earthquake fault.
No, she doesn't mean the earthquake fault. She means that place. What's the name of that place?
San Andreas fault?
She means the San Andreas fault. Yeah.
All right, San Andreas fault is her response.
Not for oh, okay, I'll take that.
And it's your fault.
Whom did you call on?
Brett.
Brett, have you got one?
Yes.
It's your fault.
Oh, it's your fault. All right, so you have it's your fault, the San Andreas fault, and no fault. Those are the three. You want one of those or one of your own?
No, don't take asphalt. Don't pay any attention to him, dear. He's trying
to make San Andreas fault.
You want that? Okay. That was Barbara's answer. Let's see if it's up there.
Sorry,
may we see the $100 number?
Barbara.
San Andreas. Got it right off the bat. What's under the next one, please?
No fault.
All right, there's Bart's answer.
It's not mine.
What do you think's on top? It's all your fault. Okay, slide it. Your fault. Now, you've got $100. That means the least you can play for is 10 times that amount or $1,000. But you got one more audience match, and you could win more with this one. May we see it, please? Blank Fitzgerald. All right.
Okay, Bill?
Ella Fitzgerald.
Ella Fitzgerald is his.
Okay, Brett?
Oh, a wonderful actress, Geraldine Fitzgerald.
Geraldine Fitzgerald.
Perhaps not the most popular now, but a wonderful actress.
You want Joyce?
Joyce.
Barry Fitzgerald.
Barry Fitzgerald. Ella Fitzgerald, Geraldine Fitzgerald. One of those or one of your own?
Ella.
Yeah. Ella.
Yeah,
all right, let's see if Ella Fitzgerald is up there. Let's take a look at the $100 number. F.
Zelda.
Scott.
Zelda.
That was the one I threw out.
Zelda, right. His daughter, Zelda. All right, let's take a look at the next one, please.
John
Fitzgerald.
Who's that?
He was a progenitor of our late president, John Fitzgerald Kennedy.
He thought he got to be Kennedy.
All right, may we see the top one, please?
Ella.
Ella. Very good. Very good. Bill gave you that one. Go up there. All right, now, Nancy. Another $500 means another $5,000 added to the previous amount gives you a pot of $6,000 to shoot for, but you're going to spin the star wheel. And if you get a lucky spin, that means you double it to $12,000. Kind of an oddball number, but we wish you well, and we'll all root for a double, right? Here we go. Are you ready, Ms. Joyce?
Third time's a charm.
Yes.
Here it is. Okay, good
third
luck
time's
to you.
We only have one card left.
This is your last card. It's
yes.
The last question. Blank in. That's I-N-N. I-double-N. Blank in. You got it?
Mm-hmm.
I-N-N. Now, Joyce has written her answer. If you give us the same one she has on the card, we give you $12,000. What do you say?
I can only think of one thing, and it's Holiday Inn.
That's a good answer, right? The audience thinks it's a super answer. Is that a good answer?
Now, wait a minute.
Joyce is writing the answer. Let's not forget.
I hate to point this out, dear, but the last couple times Joyce has done this...
Right in the dumper, boy.
Yes, she ain't done too well. Whoa. But maybe her...
Look,
maybe your luck is...
I don't even have any more cards.
That's your last card. Well, what did you put on the card? She says holiday
Gee,
and
you
lament.
You know, I went to school back east.
Yes.
And they have so many different kinds of inns. They have the George Washington Crossing Inn.
Yes.
Ramada Inn.
Right. They've got a lot of inns.
Bidawi Motel.
Wayside Inn.
But since it's near the holidays, I wrote holiday.
This message for you. We're all very happy for Nancy McCullough, who has $12,600. You do remember the name of your husband.
Oh, it's Dave.
Dave, yes, of course. Dave is very happy, too. Join us next time for Match Game PM. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game PM, a Mark Goodson, Bill Todman production.
Are you watching, you little rascals?
Oh, it's fun, isn't it?
And who subscribes to it?
Go on, push the button.
Think of the fun you could have on
the tube.
The tube?
You.
Tube.
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 Tubes.
TV tubes.
That's a lot of fun, isn't it?
It's gonna be a lot more fun
if you keep going the way you're going.
Go on, push the button.
Please subscribe.
I hope they're watching.